Hello out there to everyone in YouTube land. We've got a really cool retro build coming up. It's finally reissued, the AMT Myers Manx, the kit car you could buy and build in your garage in different levels and go and have an awesome time. They have reissued the full kit, all kinds of options in the box. We can see the box art there. And they've got some cool goodies in there that were never in there since day one. So we can start taking a look at all the stuff that will be in the box when you get yours. First up, we've got the giant Myers. It's giant because it came as one big, I think, fiberglass piece back in the day. So you can see that body there. Looks like they've paid attention to the molds on this one as well, so that it's not all full of flash. So you can see how it's going to look. We got a nice dashboard in this one. I built a version of this chassis, I think, as the Coca-Cola VW a while back. Exhaust systems, got some cooling louvers there. We have an optional top. You can see the top on the box art right there. So we do have a top for if you live in a rainy climate. Here we've got on another tree, one of the seats and a Surrey top, which is just held up with some rods as another option in there. Here's the other seat that came loose, and here's part of the steering mechanism. On some other parts trees here, we got what looks like a rear hatch for the engine, more louvered body parts, nice long whip antenna or flag mount if you're gonna go dune buggy riding. We've got a set of plastic rear tires. The other one just came off, but those are available to use. We've got steering, we've got front suspension and bumper, steering components, pedals, brake lever. On this one, we've got our main chassis and backbone, rear suspension, shock absorbers, fuel tank. That's what I was using when I built the Coca-Cola VW. On the other side of the table, we've got a new and improved decal sheet. Looks pretty awesome. I like these stripes for the hood and the roof. The number 10 logos, all kinds of Myers Manx logos. This one's cool, Volkswagen Custom Parts from Custom House. Myers Manx logos and the name, cool AMT, tater chip. Nice flame logos in two different colors. All kinds of nice stuff will freeze right there, so you can pause it, look at your new decal sheet. Then we've got a set of six, yes, six tires. We've got Firestone off-road tires for the rear, or the front if you really wanted to be different. They do say Firestone on both sides. They are black wall tires. And then a set of four Goodyear tires for street use or just the fronts. Excuse me. We've got one steel axle. We've got an extra large chrome tree. All kinds of wheel options on there. We've got our engine block, cylinder heads, mounts, all in chrome. Nice bumper skid plate for the back is right there. Very thin, so be careful. Another thin piece of steel. We got some big bug eye headlights. Like the rear suspension. Nice custom wheels, full sets of those. Nice look at the chrome tree. We've got orange tinted glass, clear and red. You can see our headlights are in there, so you can really do it up any way you want, depending on the color. The box also has frameable print of the box art in cardboard. So that 9x6 is available to you. What else is in there? Well, let's take a look at the Myers Manx manual. Myers Manx manual, MMM. They got some cool information on the ride. All the way across the back, let you know what you could order, how it all went together in real life. And then we've got our standard AMT exploded view drawings for assembly. But I want to show you the backside on that. That's all that's in the box. Not a ton of stuff, but it's going to make for a cool looking ride. I'm going to start to glue mine together right now, and we'll be right back. Subassembly time shows up without much fuss, though Chris is not a big fan of entirely chrome engines. I always end up painting them over anyways, so all it ends up, you see a lot of fogging on the chrome because I use super glue. I don't sand everything down unless it's a large piece and stuff like that. So that's how I assembled the engine. You saw me go through and assemble the front axle and then the steering and the steering box and everything. We've got our pedals installed and the backbone of the chassis. Then I took the rear suspension, super glued it in place, but first I slipped the steel axle through the engine and the two suspension pieces so that when we are all done, it all lines up perfectly. Now I can just gently pull that out, remove the little engine, install the axle again, and that will hold it steady while I get everything painted. So our chassis will look like so. My idea is to do this up as if it was really used off of a VW. So I will paint this and then I'm going to weather it a bit before we start bolting the stuff on. The engine is all assembled. It's one big chrome. I got a little bit of hair in there because of the super glue. Happens all the time. So we got our generator on there, our belt and pulley system, which is entirely chrome in these parts, our engine halves, our little starter back there, our carburation, and everything is all chrome, the cylinders and all that. So I will be priming this and then painting in a metallic tone and then going in and picking out detail for like the distributor by hand and whatnot on there, the oil filter, the oil filler and all that stuff. So, but that's what you get. The cloudiness will go away, but the super glue will cloud it up as you assemble it. It's just from the fumes that attach to that chrome surface. We've got our exhaust system here. I'll be painting all that up and then detailing it separately. We've got our fuel tank and rear shocks. I will put the rear shocks on after I get them painted a different color. Our fuel tank will be painted and our battery. I'm not sure where I'll put the battery in the body, probably in that little hump where they suggested it, but I might find another location. We got our two seats here. Those don't need any work. Those will just be painted individually. I'm going to be using a couple parts so I can interchange things in the final photos. One is this tonneau cover. It fits nicely and it looks nice and it's got this nice button rim around it that you'll be able to see me detail. I want to use the top, so I'll be detailing that as well, painting it, then adding the glass and all that. The body and the roll cage, I've got the roll cage set up. That actually goes into two holes that are marked on the bottom of the chassis, and then I drilled those holes so that when the body sits on it, I can attach the roll cage. All right. I can attach it and then put my top on when it's all glued into place, and with the glass in the top, it'll be heavier in the back, so it will hold in place. and that'll be able to demonstrate it that way with its top on and everything. The body itself didn't really use any work. Since these areas back here are very small, I will paint and then I will touch those up later. I can hold on to the body. My body spreaders and my clips won't fit on that. So that will go in there. That's where they recommend the battery to go. So that's probably where I'll put it. And then the hood has the dashboard attached. You can paint them separate. I'm going to paint them together. And our steering column. I'm going to do it as one and then accent the little very faint gauges in a little bit later. So that will go on like that. On this body, we will attach our headlights to these large posts. That's how that's all going to seal up. So we'll all be down in there. The fuel tank will end up sitting up here. Then we'll get our hood to come down and clip right over the top. We'll put our headlights in. I definitely wanted to do the Manx. I'm going to be using the off-road tires in mine, and I'm not going to be doing the street Manx, but there'll be mixtures of different things. I want to use the brush guards, front and rear, all that cool stuff. I want to use a lot of those parts. In the back, I glued the wheel pegs into the brake drums, and then we'll attach those with the wheels that I decide to use. You can use these Baby Moons. You can use the Kragers or any combination. You can use these taillights. You don't have to. You can do whatever you want. I probably will. You can use the windshield wipers. You don't have to. Depends on how you would build your Manx vehicle if you bought the kit in the real world. Depends on where you live. Are you only going to drive it in the sun? You don't need windshield wipers. Are you only going to drive it in the day? You don't need headlights. So it all depends on what you want to do with yours. But this is how I'm going to do mine. And I'm going to get mine into paint right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
my first time building up AMT's 125th scale Myers Manx kit, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. I got a chance to build the same chassis and engine before with the Coca-Cola car, the VW, the little gasser, and now I get the actual Myers Manx that it came from, and I decided to add all my own little touches to it and build it my way. I did it in that key lime green. I put the top on mine, built the... I painted and detailed the tonneau cover so you can see what it looks like, but I glued in the roll bar to hold up the roof and all that stuff, so I won't be able to attach the tonneau cover, but you can place that in the back like I showed in the parts show off, and you will have it looking nice. Now we'll take that nice little top off that I did in white. I thought with the white decal and the key lime, the white top would look awesome, and it does. So then we've got that interior there. We got the little battery in the back. We got our roll cage. We got our sport bucket seats, detailed those. Even put the windshield wipers in. Got the big bug headlights on it. I moved the gas tank cap to the hood. That is an optional location for it. And then I did put the brush guards on the front and the back. Those are options to put on as well. I thought they looked pretty awesome. Got that windshield installed. Showed you how to do the gauges on there. Installed the steering wheel, the shift lever, the pedals, and then put a very small amount of decals on it. I did do the little VW taillights with the red inserts. I liked the exhaust. And then instead of using the muffled exhaust, I did put the stinger on it. Technically not really street legal, but in this configuration, this could be anything with those Firestones in the back. It could just be a dune runner or a woods runner, so you wouldn't really need to worry about legal exhaust. Or you could put the license plate frame on it, slap a license plate on it. In a modified vehicle like this, most of the time they don't care what you run on the street because they know it's really, you know, just a custom modified vehicle. So it really is cool. I could have went with the street tires in the back. That's an option. Or the Krager wheels. But for this one, I was feeling those Firestones when I sanded them down, and I thought they looked kind of cool and definitely different and much more closely match the nice box art and the large card frameable art that they included in the box there with those Firestones on the back, and he's Bahan it through the woods. So kind of built what was the box art, but in the key lime color, which I enjoyed, and then did the headers instead of silver or black. I did them as if they were in the white Ceram coat, and since it's a very light flat white coating, a lot of the black comes through and it looks like it's actually been driven. So underneath is extremely simple. You can see the skid plates, the rear shocks, that steel axle, that's why I painted it. And then we are all set to go. So the box art doesn't have the windshield wipers. I put them on there if you're going to hit any mud or sand or anything. You want to clean that off. It's so easy to build this kit. It seems like it would be fiddly, but it's not. And the body just drops right onto the chassis and glues around the border. You wouldn't even have to glue it on if you wanted to show off that chassis or change out the roll cage and stuff like that. Put in the tonneau cover. The tonneau cover would go down and end up going in. You could even cut the tonneau cover or drill some holes to allow the roll cage to go through it and put that in there. The option's completely up to you. And then if you want, go ahead, you slip the top on. And I really think that makes it look just so much more buggy. Volkswagen-y little cute bug modified vehicle. Really glad that Round 2 Models sent this over. I will link down in the description. And remember, build your models for you. No one else. Have a great time doing it. It doesn't matter if it's a show build or just a personal build for the shelf or for a friend or for an enjoyment. As long as you're smiling and have a good time, that's what the hobby is all about. And I will see all of you at the next review.